I am roasting.
It's hot.
My God. This is thermal as well. Wowie. I didn't know which one to say, hi or hello. Sorry, I'm just gonna launch into it. Hello, I'm Aimee Lou-Wood, and these are my life lessons with Grazia. And I do say Grazia because I'm northern, but I'm here in Grazia, but I'm gonna go with Grazia. So I've actually got quite a few. Can I give a few little ones? One of them that was just very simple and very helpful was when my friend said to me, people need to try and be interested rather than interesting. As long as you stay interested in people and in everything around you, you'll just naturally be interesting to others, like staying curious. Another really good one is Shooty's classic, which is face your front. Face your front, don't be looking side to side, what are they doing, what are they doing? Just face your front, be on your own kind of trajectory. Comparison is the thief of joy, so don't be comparing. I just try to not engage with imposter syndrome. Just try and be in the here and now as much. Obviously that's hard to do. You know, the first few photo shoots that I did, I was stood there, I was thinking, what the hell am I doing here? Because I'm not a model and this isn't my comfort zone at all. The more I just tried to be in the present, the more that kind of went away. When I feel really unhealthy is when I'm stressed. I really think that stress is just so bad for us. And I think that I read this thing on the holistic psychologist, who I love, her Instagram, which was, if you've had a stressful childhood or you've been in homes that are quite turbulent and dramatic and reactive, you become addicted to your stress hormones because it's actually then become, you're so used to that level of stress and emergency and urgency that you actually recreate it in order to feel like yourself. And actually when things are okay, I'm going, okay, what's wrong? I need to figure out what's wrong. And actually, I think for me to stay healthy, it's kind of just avoid stress as much as possible. So just, yeah, stress is a no-go. This is still quite a big one for me. I think that the best thing is, like, be really committed to being honest. It's never too late to say, actually, when we were together a couple of days ago, you said something that did upset me. And I think make it about, you know, feelings rather than blame. I think a lot of the time people go straight to kind of like, you did this and you did that. And that's when people's defenses go up. Whereas if you kind of say that I felt hurt when this happened, no one can really argue with that because you're allowed your feelings. Because if you can't trust that you'll be safe when you express yourself, then they're probably not a friend. So I think as much as it can be painful, sometimes we avoid talking to certain people because we don't trust them. Goodbye. My current feeling on this, if my friends are going through stuff and there's a ghosting going on, if they're doing the ghosting, I'll be like, come on, not okay. Like, it's better for that, like, that moment of discomfort where you have to say, so sorry, I just didn't really feel a connection. But having that little moment of discomfort and saving that person a world of pain in the long run than just, like, again, ignoring it and kind of... But I would say if you're on the receiving end, what I would want to say would be, you know, hi, excuse me, can we have a chat? But I know that can be the scariest thing in the world to do. It's a hard one, because I never want to give my friends advice. I'm currently on this thing where I'm like, when they ask me for advice, I'll be like, you already know what to do. And I try and not insert myself into it too much. But my thing is kind of like, just get it over and done with, because they're going to keep you in purgatory. Like, you need to just say, I think if I was getting ghosted, I would say, excuse me, are you ghosting me? Because if you are, that's absolutely fine, but I don't want you to waste my time. I really do think it is connection, like actual genuine connection, because you can be out in the world around so many people, so many friends, and feel really lonely because you're not actually connecting on an authentic level. It can be worse, it can be even lonelier if you're surrounded by people but you feel alone. That's like the most horrible feeling. So I think just connecting to yourself, having time alone to really just connect with you and, you know, look at the bloody trees and read and, you know, watch films and listen to music and just kind of just stay as connected with yourself as possible, because then you'll just find connecting with others so much easier. I think we feel like we have to choose. It's this weird thing that we have where when you're 16, they say, so what do you want to do with your life, darling? And you have to kind of like decide what you're going to do for the rest of your life in that like UCAS meeting at school. And it's, of course, it's going to change. And I think actually allowing yourself to change, you don't have to do one job for your whole life. It might be, I mean, acting currently does fulfill me, but in a few years I might go, I actually don't feel that anymore. I want to open up a bloody astrology center with Shruti. That's the current backup plan. But you know, it's okay to say, I don't want to do this anymore. This doesn't make me happy anymore. I think we see it as giving up but you're giving up on yourself by not doing that. So I think just, yeah, allow for change would be the summary. Grazia. 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 What are your star signs?